Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading The War of Betony. This is the Daggerfall version. Previously I had read the Sentinel version. It's a very different book. And I bought this here at Syncroft's Best Sundries here in Syncroft, Daggerfall region. The War of Betony. The history of the Iliac Bay, if told in its entirety, would horrify readers more than the most gruesome legend of the Enderking. In comparison to the wars of the First and Second Era, our most recent appeal to arms, the War of Betony, pales. The Siege of Orsinium lasted from First Era 950 until First Era 980 without a pause. 1,000 years later, the Thracian Plague, coupled with the War of Righteousness, slayed over half the population of the Iliac Bay. And yet, the War of Betony fascinates us, and not just because of its immediacy. Ironically, Lord Mograph of Betony was seeking peace when he asked for Daggerfall's protection on the Isle of Betony. The island had long been independent, but as the piracy in the bay increased, Mograph truly realized Betony's vulnerability. King Lysandus agreed to be Betony's liege, on advice of many, including his Archpriest of Kinnereth, Lord Vanek. While Betony is a prosperous fishing island and well-placed strategically, the vassalage of Betony was primarily an act of charity. Lysandus knew that if someone did not help Betony, it would fall to the pirates, if not to someone worse. Unfortunately, King Cameron of Sentinel did not agree. Citing a 200-year-old contract, obliquely if not illegally written to suggest that Betony was a traditional holding of the Kingdom of Sentinel, Cameron declared war. The majority of his advisors, being warlords in a traditionally bellicose country, supported their king in this. The chief counselor, a woman called the Oracle, foresaw death and defeat in the war, but her wisdom was stifled and she was banished from court. Cameron should have listened to her. A few scrimmages of the War of Betony went to Sentinel, but the major battles were all won by Daggerfall. King Lysandus, his heir Prince Gothred, and the general of the army, Lord Bridwell, were fine leaders and warriors as well, and the Battle of the Bluffs and the Siege of Craghold both went to Daggerfall. The war might have been won with one more victory, but for an unusual domestic incident in King Lysandus's court. The king's mother, the Dowager Queen Nolfaga, had been uneasy about the war since its beginning, but she now began to have visions of cataclysm. She saw the death of her beloved son should the war continue. Ebullient by his success, King Lysandus refused to listen to her fears until Nolfaga left court. Lysandus then realized how certain she was about his impending death. He began to actively negotiate a peace treaty with Sentinel, using the neutral lordship of Reich Gradkeep as facilitator. The Treaty of Reich Gradkeep was never to be. King Cameron was initially civil, as the losing side of a war is often civil, but when he realized that the proposed treaty would have included a formal declaration that the kingdoms of Sentinel and Daggerfall would share Betony, he flew into a rage. With no thought for the protocol of attacking a neutral, peaceable lordship, Cameron ordered his army to riot through Reich Gradkeep. First the halls of the palace, and then the streets of the capital ran red with blood. It was only with the support of the Daggerfall army that the chaos was brought under relative control. The Sentinel army fled to the Yorth Burrowland, and the Daggerfall army chased them as far as the Ravenian Forest before making camp. 1 week later, after each had a chance to send for reinforcements and plan their strategies, the armies met in the field that separated them, the flowering meadowland called Cringane Field. In the heat of the clash, an unnatural fog spread over the field, blinding all combatants. When the mist finally lifted, King Lysandus's body was found, his throat pierced by an unmarked arrow. Daggerfall did not waste any time in mourning. Young Prince Gothred, who had shown great bravery in battle and was very popular among the troops, was crowned King of Daggerfall just behind the battle lines, and he ordered the army onward. Perhaps it was the sight of the brave young warrior turned king appearing on the battlefield in full regalia that inspired the Daggerfall army. Perhaps the battle would have turned regardless. Sentinel began to panic. King Gothred met King Cameron before the Red Guards had retreated, and the two monarchs fought. Both were excellent warriors, but Gothred was a more skillful swordsman, and Cameron fell that day. Lord Eresme of Sentinel formally surrendered to Daggerfall, giving up all rights to Betony officially. He later committed suicide on the ship back to Sentinel. Peace was a difficult process for the cities and towns on both sides of the Iliac Bay. As part of the formal peace treaty, King Gothred asked for the hand of Princess Obakai, only daughter of the late King Cameron and the Queen Regent Akarithi. The request was intended to restore friendship between the kingdoms, and it was partially successful, though many in the royal court of Sentinel viewed the princess as more a prisoner of war than a bond to Daggerfall. The only surviving member of the ruling family of Reich Gradkeep was a sickly infant, so the councillors of state appealed to Lord Oberon Flight, a cousin of Lord Gradock, to rule the lordship in regency. Lord Flight accepted, and his strong, almost dictatorial style was just what Reich Gradkeep needed to restore order after the bloody treaty of Reich Gradkeep. His subjects were grateful that when the infant heir died, they not only elevated his wife Doriana and him from regents to rulers, they agreed to rename the lordship in his honor. Reich Gradkeep became Anticlare, named after his ancestral home. The horrors of the War of Betony still live on, even in Anticlare. Whether Daggerfall and Sentinel will be able to use the marriage of King Gothred and Princess Obakai as a symbol of peace rather than discord is something that only the future can show. 14 Sun's Dawn, Third Era, 404. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall, The War of Betony.